While there was not much in the way of news this weekend, Nick Saban did turn some heads with comments regarding his stance on NIL and the transfer portal. Now, Saban spoke Thursday night at the 18th annual Alabama Football Coaches Association convention. That's in Montgomery. And they talked about NIL's impact on recruiting during a Q&A. Now, he said, "Someone with one of the best corners in the nation in high school came to me and asked if we would pay them $800,000 for the player to sign here. And I told him he can find another place to play," Saban said, according to Steve Norman, who is the head coach at Baker High School in Mobile. Norman added that Saban said, "I'm not paying a kid a bunch of NIL money before he earns it." Now, the ALFCA president, Terry Curtis, confirmed the statement from Saban regarding the transfer portal. Saban said, "We lost 10 players and one starter to the portal this year. One of them wanted $500,000 and for us to get his girlfriend into law school at Alabama, and for Alabama to pay for it." Saban said, "I showed him the door." Now, this is all from Curtis. Curtis said he was explaining that this tells you where this NIL and transfer portal are going. I thought he made an excellent point. He said, "It's crazy what some kids are asking for." Coach Saban was talking about how frustrating it is to deal with NIL and the portal, and how there needs to be some more ground rule. Now, Saban did not name names, but regarding the recruit, it is assumed that he was discussing Cormani McClain, who is the number one cornerback in the nation for the 2023 class out of Lakeland, Florida. McClain first committed to Miami, who's been throwing around NIL money thanks to the booster John Ruiz. McClain decommitted from Miami and committed last week to Deion Sanders in Colorado. Now, regarding the transfer, the only starter that transferred out of Alabama was the offensive lineman, left guard Javion Cohen, who ended up transferring to, of all places, Miami. Cohen started much of the last two seasons at Alabama. So what I want to do here is kind of break this down. First, I found it a little bit odd about the recruit. Saban said, "I'm not paying a kid a bunch of NIL money before he earns it." Now, this is all speculation, of course, because there doesn't appear to be any recordings of Saban saying it. But to put himself in the position of the person that's actually paying the kids is a bit weird, right? Now, looking at the player that wanted $500,000 for his girlfriend to be let into law school on Alabama's dime, none of this is technically NIL, right? Why would a player that's already on the team at Alabama feel comfortable enough to go ask the coach for something like that? Now, it's definitely something to think about, as coaches are not supposed to be involved with NIL dealings, although, if we're being honest with ourselves, a lot of them absolutely are involved. But back to the point, this is what coaches have been complaining about. NIL was never supposed to be a recruiting incentive. This was supposed to be the Olympic model. If your name, image, or likeness provided value to a brand or business, they could pay you. Otherwise, you just work to get to the league and make your money there. But alas, here we are. Other coaches that were in attendance, by the way, or that were also speakers at the event, were Kirby Smart, Sam Pittman, Josh Heupel, and Hugh Freeze. So something to pay attention to. A lot of it was weird. Why would Saban put himself in the position of saying, like, "I'm not going to pay a kid"? Like, that's kind of insinuating that you already have. And there's a lot of rumors and everything else that go around about this. But even still, it's a weird spot. Weird spot.
Hey, if you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and of course, jump in the comments.
Thanks for listening to Winning Cures Everything. Make sure and subscribe on YouTube or your favorite podcast app, and make sure to leave a nice 5-star review. You can follow Gary on Twitter at GaryWCE, and the show is at Winning Cures. Be sure to check out the merch in our web store and share the show.